Oh yeah, I got it.
Oh wow, look at you. Look at you.
Jabu turned out to be a really loving and wonderful guy.
Oh, baloney.
He is my world. Our whole lives are oriented around caring for them.
Our turn.
Hey. Who's next? Whoa, careful, Jabu.
Easy, Jabu, Lani. Easy with those joints, my boy.
Just a few months ago, he fell into a hole, and that really kind of displaced the joint.
So you see this old rounded termite mound, it was just out past that, and as he stepped with his left front, it just sank completely. When he came out straight away, I saw he could like barely move. He needs to be out here every day feeding,
yeah.
And of course they need to cover a fair amount of ground when they're feeding.
We realized that his situation was dire. So we reached out to a number of different vets, both internationally and locally. A lot of people had been very discouraging. Derrick's response was a fairly positive straight off the bat. I feel that his situation is fairly critical now. One more really bad injury, and it may be past the point of return.
So yeah, let me see that leg. A pretty severe angle inward, and that means he's experiencing a lot of pressure on the outside of his carpus. If you think of it like a human knee, people that have osteoarthritis, when their knees are in like this, that space is smaller, and so you get a lot of meniscus wearing away, a lot of bone on bone. I'm only gonna have a few days here in Botswana and I'm to adapt this brace and hopefully I can get to a level where Jabu's wearing this and feels comfortable before I go home. The carpal brace we're making is kind of pushing here, pushing inward this way and pushing it on here. And those forces will bring the leg in a little bit more straighter of a position. If this is his leg and it's straight, his leg is kind of curved at the wrist. One of the sides collapses under this joint. As that angle increases, there's even more bone on bone. It gets to the point where Jabu may not be able to walk at all, and if he can't walk, then he can't live.